Hi, I'm Tony Clark from the Jimmy Carter Presidential Library and Museum. Welcome to the Library and Museum. I'd like to show you around because I think it's a fascinating way to learn about the life and career of President Jimmy Carter. He grew up in Plains, Georgia, in Archery, Georgia, just outside of Plains. That's the picture of his house where he grew up. But the important thing about that is he grew up during segregation, when blacks and whites were kept separate, when they were treated differently. He saw the harm of segregation, and it shaped everything that he has done throughout his life. It showed him the importance of human rights, and he has worked for that as governor, as president, and after leaving the White House. Human rights has been the centerpiece of Jimmy Carter's career. One of the big influences on Jimmy Carter's life was his school teacher, Julia Coleman. That's Julia Coleman. She was not only his school teacher, she was principal of the high school in Plains, Georgia. It's also interesting in looking at his report card that back then, his teacher used to check his teeth. And she's got it written in here that his teeth were okay, that he had good teeth, which is interesting because when he runs for president, all the cartoons, all the caricatures of him are this big toothy grin. So Julia Coleman was checking on him even back then. In 1976, Jimmy Carter ran for president of the United States. The country had been through Watergate, the Vietnam War. Trust in government was really low. He was a little-known former Southern governor, and the voters decided to try somebody new, somebody that they felt they could trust. And Jimmy Carter won. In fact, when he won the presidency and when he was being inaugurated, he did something unusual for presidents. In the ride down Pennsylvania Avenue, he and Mrs. Carter, their family, Amy, all got out of the car and walked to try to show that they were of the people. In fact, the coats the three of them are wearing are on display here in the museum. The interesting thing to me is the coat President Carter was wearing wasn't his coat. When he was campaigning for the presidency in Iowa or New Hampshire, he's getting ready for a TV interview outside. And he had on a light colored coat, kind of like this one. And his media advisor went up to him and said, "Governor, your face is going to look all washed out on camera if you wear that coat." So his media advisor loaned him his coat. This coat, and Jimmy Carter never gave it back. In fact, the media advisor comes through here periodically and he says he wants a tag on that coat that says that's on loan from him and not the president. This is one of the coolest places in the museum. It's our exact replica of the Oval Office. It's decorated the way it was when President Carter's in office. It is the exact size of the Oval Office in the White House. Everything in here is a reproduction except the ship, the presidential flag, the globe, the chair, the stuff on the desk. Those were all actually in the White House in the Oval Office when Jimmy Carter was president. President Carter arranged the furniture different than most presidents. Most presidents have the sofas face each other that allows a lot of people to talk. President Carter decided to make kind of a formal area in front of the desk and an informal area over by the fireplace. It is the most famous room in the White House, and it's a great chance to come into the museum and take your picture in the Oval Office so that you can have the desk over your shoulder. It looks like you're just waiting to see the president, or you're the president yourself. Countries often give presents to one another. They're gifts from the people of one country to another country, and we call them state gifts. We have a number of them on display here. Some of the more interesting ones are a silver elephant from Sri Lanka. What's really cool about that is there was an actual elephant that was given. It's at the National Zoo in Washington, D.C., and you can go on YouTube and see that elephant play the harmonica. Or there's a portrait of President Carter that was given from Mexico. From a distance, when you look at it, it's a portrait, but you get up close, you'll notice his right hand is really just a masted ship. His left arm is downtown Plains, Georgia. All the flags of the United States are in his hair and forehead. It's really cool. One other of the coolest state gifts is an embroidery. It was given by Deng Xiaoping in China. And it's done on silk that you can see through. There's a kitten and a praying mantis. And if you look at it on one side, you can't see the kitten and Manus on the other side. They are exactly overlapped. Jimmy Carter has been probably the most active former president in U.S. history. And one of the really fun things to do here at the Carter Presidential Museum is to look at the work the Carters, President and Mrs. Carter, have done and their staff at the Carter Center over the years to try and improve the health and democracy of people all around the world. Our interactive table lets you take a trip with the Carters around the world to see work that they do. For example, you can go to Ghana for guinea worm, and a plane flies and you can see where you're going, where Ghana is, and you can learn about the Carters' work on trying to reduce guinea worm. There were 3.5 million cases of guinea worm when the Carters started working on it, and they have almost got that eradicated at this point. Or you can go to other locations. You can come back to the United States and you can learn about Mrs. Carter's work and mental health. She is probably one of the foremost advocates of mental health in the country. And you can take a quiz about mental health, test your knowledge about mental health. It's a great way to learn about the work of the Carter Center, all here at this interactive table. You can spend hours here learning about the work of the Carter Center. It's really a lot of fun. Over the years, President and Mrs. Carter have received numerous awards. President Clinton gave them the Presidential Medals of Freedom. It's the highest civilian awards given to Americans. In fact, President Clinton said, "The Carters have done more good for more people in more parts of the world than any other couple on the face of the earth." But perhaps the biggest award is over here. It is President Carter's Nobel Peace Prize. When you get a Nobel Peace Prize, you get about $1 million, but you also get 3 medallions. You get a gold and you get 2 bronze. President Carter gave us one of his bronzes so you can see the front and back. The interesting thing about the Nobel Peace Prize is Atlanta is one of 2 places in the world where there are 2 Nobel Peace Prizes on display close to each other. Martin Luther King's is about 1.5 miles down the road. The other place is Soweto, South Africa. Desmond Tutu and Nelson Mandela both received the Nobel Peace Prize. The other interesting thing is, before President Obama got his Nobel Peace Prize, there were 3 U.S. presidents that had received it. Teddy Roosevelt for a treaty between Russia and Japan, Woodrow Wilson for his work on the League of Nations, and Jimmy Carter for his peace work. The interesting part of that is, Teddy Roosevelt's mom is from Roswell, Georgia, but 1/2 hour up Highway 400 from here. Woodrow Wilson was born in Virginia, but he was raised in Augusta, Georgia. His first job as a lawyer was here in Atlanta, Georgia. Jimmy Carter, born and raised in Georgia. Which makes you think, if you've got personal ties to the state of Georgia, and then you become president of the United States, you are almost guaranteed one of these. One of the awards that President Carter's grandkids like the most, though, is his Grammy Award. He's the only president to have received 2 of them. That's one of the 2. And as I say, he's the only president to have received 2 Grammy Awards. Fortunately, they are in spoken word. We don't ask him to sing. Well, thank you for coming along for a visit at the Carter Presidential Library and Museum. I'm glad you've been able to take this virtual tour. Now we just want to see you here in person. Come see us soon. Thanks.